Lindy Hopper. Famous of these, of course, was Bing Crosby. Crosby never sang at the Cotton Club, however. All the way through to the 40s, the Cotton Club was black entertainers for a white audience. Fortunately, it changed during the 40s. But here's a song from the 30s, which was done at the Cotton Club, a tune entitled 100 Years From Today.
Thank you. Don't say me kisses, just pass them around. You know my reason is logically sound. Who's gonna know that you pass them around? 100 years from today, why pray a man has this fit for a queen? You're nearer heaven on Mother Earth's brain. If you had millions, what would they all be? 100 years from today. So laugh and sing, make love your thing, be happy while you may. There's always one beneath the sun that's bound to make you feel that way. Cling to me, darling, and say you'll be mine. The moon is shining, that's a good sign. You know we both won't see it shine. 100 years from today, 100 years from today.
We'll be right back. time to welcome back to the stage Marlene Hill to sing a Bessie Smith song entitled You've Got the Right Key, But You're Working at the Wrong Keyhole. First of all, deal with the mighty gold-plated whelk at the back. It is, in fact, a sousaphone, but the sousaphone player's affinity with shellfish doesn't just end with the shape of that instrument. It actually comes from Hastings and is a member of the famous Hastings Winkle Club. Now, if you're a member of the Winkle Club in Hastings and you go into a public house and somebody shouts, "Winkle up," you have to produce your winkle or buy a round of drinks. I know I'm from Hastings as well. And I have to tell you that summer and even in the winter, Alan can always produce his winkle. It's a little gold one he wears on his belt. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Alan Soker. Let's pass swiftly over that collection of old stuff in the middle. Pass on to this fine figure of a human being here, ladies and gentlemen. Would you just sort of turn your face to the side and give them a shot of your profile? Now look at that. Look at that fine profile. Now if you cast your mind to what's on the back of a £10 note, you see there's something broadly similar. It is in fact a portrait of Charles Darwin is responsible for a tract entitled The Origin of Species. This gentleman is responsible for several species of his own. He's still paying alimony for most of them. He's also had the distinction of being the band leader and paymaster general
He also needs planning permission merely to stand up. He plays a tenor banjo, which is an instrument, not what he paid for it. Actually, only paid a five. And a four-string guitar, because he's so poor paying us, he can't afford the other two strings. Ladies and gentlemen, mountainous Boris Storm. Last, but by all means least, a man who recently has been dragged kicking and screaming into the 20th century when his lovely girlfriend has finally persuaded him to buy an electric piano. How many years is that, Martin?
40.
40. Yes. Next week he's going to put a plug on the lead. But tonight he's playing a real instrument. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you our fine pianist, Mr. Martin Lynn.
Meg's talked about Morris playing alimony, and another person that didn't often play his alimony was the great pianist Fats Waller. And he was always being thrown in jail for non-payment to his first wife. Otherwise, he was a pretty fun-loving character. I'm going to play one of his pieces now, a thing called The Viper's Drag. Of course, nothing to do with snakes. Viper in the 1930s. Well, that was slang for someone who was addicted to funny cigarettes and things like that. And the Fats himself was more addicted to old granddad gin. And an older colleague of mine met a man who'd actually seen Fats Waller perform in the 1930s. And apparently he came on stage dressed in tails, sat down, promptly fell backwards. And that was the end of the performance. Of course, I really touched the stuff. So this should be all right. I'll stay on the piano stool and I will be assisted by a mystery drummer.
Thank you.